I'm not gonna give you the money though. We discussed about if the cell, your white blood cell fails to recognize it, we kill it, right? Autoimmune disease, right? So these are marker molecules. The post office can decide for internal use or export. Okay, what was the term used if lysosome kills the cell? Apoptosis. But if it does digestion, that will be detoxification. And if it eats worn out organelles, like if it eats its own self-eating, you know. Autophagy. Let's do one more. ER, what does it produce? Protein, because it has got ribosomes. Right. Okay. So our first exam would be on Thursday next week, right? Right, so on Thursday, the exam is to just check if you are understanding it, or if you don't understand it, that's when you're gonna gauge the whole semester, so it's gonna have 50 points. Okay. If you get greater than 25, out of 50, then it's easier for you to adjust and cruise. But if you get less than 25, I encourage you to talk to me, because it will be hard for you to enjoy the course as it gets harder. Okay. If you get above 25, we can adjust it and then you'll have a very successful semester. But if you get 10 and you don't talk to me, cannot do anything. But if it is above this, I can give you some tips and you can do better. So for that, I'll release the study guide and I'll show you how to study, okay? All right? Today, at the end. So epithelial and connective tissues. So we covered cell and then the epithelial and connective tissues, the bone, and we'll continue. So this chapter is included in your exam one. So cells that has similar structure but specialized function, they form tissues. So cells combine to form tissues. The study of tissues called histology. Hist means tissue. What is the study of cells? Cytology. So these are the four types of tissue. Epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscle, and nerve tissue. So when you see the function and the location of each tissues are different. Epithelial, they cover body surfaces. They also attach it to glands, and they cover body cavities. Connective tissue, three things you have to know, they support. They connect and fluid. Connective tissue is basically the blood and lymph. Okay. But within this function, we have loose, dense, regular, irregular, and we'll see that. Muscle, this is for connective tissue. For a muscle, we have three types: skeletal, cardiac, and smooth. Their locations are different. This would be attached to the bones. This cardiac would be on the heart. The smooth would be internal organs. But the whole function of muscle would be movement. In this case, blood movement, food movement, the person, the organism as a whole will move. Okay. Nervous tissue, which we'll see in detail in the nervous system, has got sensory function, motor function, integrative function. So if detects changes, it adjusts changes, and with the motor, you respond to it. So it's important for support and maintenance of all other tissues. So this is where we discuss structural organization from the smallest, like molecules are from atoms, and molecules form organelles, cells, and tissue. Tissue are divided epithelial, connective, muscle, and nervous. So group of tissue will form organs and organ system. Okay. Now let's start with epithelial tissues. Epithelial tissues, they have specific characteristics. One means they are next to each other, they're packed. Cellularity, sits shoulder to shoulder. One cell is connected to another cell, connected to another cell, connected to another cell. There is no intracellular spaces. Okay. They have basement membrane. And they can have surfaces, right? What do we call the surface which is exposed to the outside? Free surface or apical surface. Attach it to the basement membrane. Basal surface. And next to each other, which is lateral surface. they have polarity. That means the lateral surface always stays on lateral, the apical to the apical, the basal to the basal. And this is a term we use today, like in politics, Republicans are Republicans, Democrats are Democrats, right? They are polarized. That means they stay on their base. Okay? That's the term. Polarity means. Avascular, that means they don't have blood vessel. You see that there is no blood vessel, but here in the connective tissue there is blood vessel. So how do they give their nutrient? For example, if you take this stratified squamous epithelium, how does this get nutrient? If there is a blood vessel down here, there is a blood vessel here in the connective tissue, things will go into this by diffusion. So from this we can see that they have their own preference sinus, which is polarity. All epithelial tissues, they have a basement membrane attachment. They are next to each other, cellularity, and they don't have blood vessels, and vascular, that means without a blood vessel, so they get their nutrient by diffusion. Let's see the bigger picture of this. What happens if they lose this arrangement? For example, if one cell decides I'm gonna be like this, the other one, I'm gonna be like this, the other one like this. And the basement membrane is here. It's cancerous cell. That means when tissue biopsies are taken in a hospital, they see, are the cells next to each other, do they keep their polarity? If they lost their polarity, they become tumor. They become cancer. That means they have lost their communication. Every cell become autonomous and crazy. Without control, grows, so it will increase in size. But what keeps them in this position is called junctional complex. Junctional complex. That means if you take two cells, they have the nucleus, they have a belt-like structure that puts them in position. That means it prevents the leakage of things between them. It has got attachment, bless you. And then there is a hole that passes between the cell. So this structures, here you have a basement membrane, and these are the junctional complexes, which is, you can see that height junction, which rotates around, adherent junction, which supports this disc, and desmosomes like weld spot. And then this is what's called gap junction. That means message from here will go through this to the cell. You know, that has got gap junction. You've done it in your histology drawing in anatomy too. This is between the cells, it's the gap junction. That means signal from the cell goes to the next cell. Intercalated disc in cardiac muscle. that's a gap junction, so that the heart cell contracts every time. So this is what keeps the cell in polarity. That means when the cell goes crazy, it loses all this arrangement. So what are the junctional complex? They give you polarity, which is at the top. We have tight junction, sealing junction. That means things cannot go in between the cells, which is a belt around the cell. Adherent junction, structure is supports the cell. So it's closer to the tight junction. Desmosomes, these are like a weld spot between the cells. And then gap junction, which is called communicating junction, which is intercalated disc, for example, on the cardiac cells. And then epithelial cells, they have innervation. That's why you can touch surfaces and you can say it's rough, smooth, it's hot, it's cold, it's painful, because you have the nerve ending to sense that. Regeneration, the inside layer replaces the top layer. For example, if you go here, this layer replaces the top layer always, so they have the ability to regenerate. So these are the six characteristics of epithelia. In your study guide, says understand the characteristics of epithelia. Okay? Just understand the characteristics of connective tissue. What are some of the characteristics of connective tissue? Connective tissue. Support the function, but characteristics. We see connective tissue. One cell is here, another cell is here, right? They're not next to each other. They have blood vessels, right? That means they are vascular. Epithelial is avascular. But there is a gap. How do they fill the gap between them? Extracellular matrix, that means they have fibers, they have goo, which is like a glue that keeps them ground substance. Okay. That's how you differentiate epithelial tissue from connective tissue. You don't see basement membrane. Going to summarize the epithelial tissues we see, which will help you in study. Okay? Epithelial tissues. It's going to be different from what happened in the lab, but the concept is the same. So epithelial tissue could be one layer, or it could be two or more. What do we call it? One layer. Simple. This one? Stratified. Okay? Simple. Could be? Okay? Cuboidal. Squamous. Squamous. Pseudo-stratified. That means false stratification. Everything reaches the the basement. So pseudo stratified is here. P, C, C, E. Pseudo stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. It's a single layer. So what should be here?
Transitional.
Okay, if it is stratified squamous, it could be with this or with this. It could be keratinized or non-keratinized. Basically, this is a spare example that you navigate the epithelial tissues. So when it's simple, you can see that a single layer. What would be the function? Diffusion, that means exchange, right? Exchange. Because it's single layer, things can't go in and out. Cuboid up. Where do you find it?
Ducts.
You find it in duct. So what does the duct do? Transport. Your salivary gland produces saliva. The salivary duct transports the saliva to the oral cavity. Columnar, secrete, and absorb. Okay. Which is, you can see that columnar, tall, they will have microvilli, cuboidal, cuboidal is for transporting. That is many layer stratified squamous non keratinized. Why is it non keratinized? The top layer you see nucleus, that means keratin is not formed yet. So the function of this stratified squamous non keratinized is physical protection. It lubricates the top, so from dehydration, abrasion, exposure to infection. Selective permeability. What's selective permeability? That's one characteristic of a cell. Yeah, for example, can water get into the cell? Yes, it selects water. Can sodium chloride get into the cell? It loses its water to dilute it, but sodium, it gets into the channel. So it chooses which one to allow or which one to export. That is the function of selective permeability, which is transport and gatekeeper. It can secrete or absorb. So when it absorbs, it's endocytosis. When it secretes, it's exocytosis. So you can see that here is a nerve. Epithelial tissue have sensation. Epithelia working together with the nerve endings, you can tell surface pressure, touch, temperature, pain, and neuroepithelia for special senses. What are those special senses? Closer to the epithelia, yes? Smelling, gustatory, which is tasting a food. So those are closer to the epithelium, so you get this function, protection. Selective permeability is a producing or absorbing, and sensation, okay? Which is here, the cell shape, could be squamous, is a flat, cuboidal is a cube, columnar is a top. Layer arrangement, two or more, you call it stratified. So when you see simple squamous, which is the first group, they're like tiles or fried egg. If you see it from the top, This is a white part, this is the yolk. It's like a toasted egg. Allows rapid movement of molecules so things can cross easily.